G'day guys, back again. This time around, I thought we'd have a look at this very nice figure from The Body. 135 scale, World War II series, and it is 35081, SS Panzer Recon Officer, number 2. I pretty much picked this figure up just because of the pose. It's a bit of a different style to most figures, with his hands in his pockets, and he's got a really nice sort of lean on him as well, with his knee sort of pointing out forward, the coat sort of being held back by the arms. And just his leg stance, I think, is very nice. Very realistic. Camo top and bottom. And then you've got the sort of plain trench coat over the top. I give this poser probably a good 9 out of 10. Maybe even 10 out of 10. I just really like the pose. Let's have a look at him. So as you can see, it's going to be a very quick figure to put together. Just basically gluing the head on. And that's it for parts. Probably the only real beef I'd have with this is the way probably the head's being done. It's nothing major, but just the way they've cast it along the back there. The actual resin connecting it is very, very thin, but I much prefer it when the block is on the bottom of the neck rather than on the back there. And as you can see with the resin connection points on the actual figure, on the body itself, it's very thin flash, so it's no real big deal. And obviously if you wanted to get more detail, you need more connection points. So I can understand that, the way of the coat coming down at the back there. I'll just take this resin block off his head and I'll stick it on for you. His head's on now. His neck's a nice length. You obviously can cut it down a bit, but it sort of does stick out a little bit more than some of the other resin heads I've got. The other thing that I do really like with sometimes I do find with Evolution Miniatures figures a little bit annoying is that I really do like it when you have a movable head. Some of the sculptors might not like me saying this, but it is nice when you always have the option that if you're wanting to change your head or put this head on a different figure and use a different head for this figure. I really do like that when people have their heads separately. Sometimes it's nice just to mix up different figures. If you don't want everyone wearing, 7 or 8 guys wearing helmets and no one's wearing a cap or something different, it's nice to have sort of a couple of different headgear in a diorama. Beautiful stance. Love his hands in his pockets there. Also really like his baggy trousers. Gives the impression of being a bit shorter because he's got the really baggy trousers on. And his hands in his pockets, and because of the thickness of the trousers, I think it looks like the figure's a little bit shorter, which is nice. But rather than having all tall, skinny figures, it's nice to have a combination of figures in dioramas. Didn't really have any issues on taking the head off at all, other than you do get a little bit of resin at the back where you cut off there, and I did my best to cut it off as neat as I could. It does leave a little bit of a mark in resin, very little tiny mark. And what I did, maybe not too successful, is just jab my hobby knife in there just to try and texture the hair back a little bit where the resin was. Some really nice creases on the back of the coat here. And just from every angle, I think this figure looks very nice, which is very helpful if you're placing him in a diorama or beside a vehicle. Some figures you really need to sort of place on one particular angle to really get the full benefit of the pose. But this figure here, I think pretty much in most angles you could place him. The emblems on the belt and the cap, and hopefully it'll show up in the video, are just a little bit soft when you're comparing it to maybe one of the new Alpine Miniatures figures or Evolution Miniatures figures. Just the detail on them is just a little bit less defined than some of the newer figures. But I will say it's pretty hard to find decent figures like this with the hands in the pockets and the coat on. I know Alpine Miniatures has done one or two in German and US figures in the past. But the only other thing, and I'm not sure because it's very hard to see in this scale, is his right ear here, if you can see. I think it might have been chipped off a little bit. I can't tell if it's chipped off or it's under the cap. But to me, it looks like it might have been chipped off a little bit compared to his other one. But no biggie, and I'm not even sure if that's the case. But I just thought I'd point it out, obviously, because I'm doing this little review. I really like figures that have binoculars attached to them. I think it's just an extra thing that you can paint and detail up very well to just add a little bit more realism to the figure. And it's obviously another thing, he's got it connected already, so the straps are coming down and connected to them. If you're looking for this figure, my advice would be to go out and pick him up, because some of these figures from certain companies, or if they're smaller companies, can sort of disappear and they become very hard to find later on. So if you do like this figure, my advice would be to go and pick him up rather than wait for a long time. And then he might be out of stock. highly rate this figure. 135 scale SS Panzer Recon Officer from the body. Thanks for watching, and I'll catch you later.